This is lecture number 9 about early posture. When considering young children, and I'm talking here about very young children in their first few years of life, one might wonder how they develop good or bad posture. And I don't think anyone can say for sure, but there's no doubt that posture is influenced hugely by early nasal allergies. Every child at birth is a compulsive nose breather, because in the womb, if they inhaled the fluid, they would it would be fatal. Anyway, the ability to breathe through the nose is there from the very start. But as parents become, or the child becomes older, the actual difficulties of breathing arise because, I think, mainly of allergies. And these are particularly present in the household where we have this dust I mentioned previously. Once a child has been had a blocked nose for a period of time, they're very likely to develop the habit of breathing through their mouth. And once they have this habit, it can be quite difficult to break. But this habit often starts in the first 1 or 2 years of life. And it is very difficult to change until they are older. And by then, some children will never change. Now, one of the problems is that if you start to breathe through your mouth, then your nose is more likely to block. This is simply because the mucus, which is excreted from the cells in the nose, has no air going through the nose and therefore tends to collect. And this is what blocks the nose. So if you can persuade a child to breathe through their nose, the airway will often open automatically, and this is made use of with the buteyko technique, which some people know of. I used to try and encourage children to keep their lips together by putting little vertical strips of tape each side. But this was some 30 years ago, and I was accused of child cruelty. Ideas change. Now, the early view was that the airway was blocked by the tonsils and adenoids. This always seemed to me a little bit unlikely. Now, I was influenced by the research of Brian Preston using tomographs, and he found that the tonsils and adenoids very rarely obstruct the airway. They're a nuisance and can be inflamed, but they very rarely provide a major obstruction. It was that which got me involved in early expansion, and I found that if you expand a child maybe up to 8 millimetres, and beyond that age, 10 millimetres, you will always open the airway, always. However, of course, if the child then doesn't naturally breathe through their nose, the airway will often obstruct again, rendering the treatment useless. But if you can, in the meanwhile, train them to naturally breathe through their nose and keep their tongue on the palate, then they will be able to do so for the rest of their life. The prepubertal growth spurt of about 8 years old tends to expose any vertical growth tendency, and you'll find the incisors erupt down, and at that particular time the child goes through a growth spurt, and many parents find that their child changes looks radically at about this age. You can see in the slides what I'm suggesting. And therefore, it is very important that one tries to treat before the age of 8. maybe even before the age of seven, that particular dental changeover coupled with the growth spurt can cause a lot of damage. Anyway, I find that most orthodontists are actually unaware of this dangerous point. Of course, they don't treat until the age of 12 to 14, by when the damage has already been done and the child has a much longer face. But in my mind, a much better time to treat is at the age of 6, 7, 8, when you can really influence the growth rather than waiting to try and correct it.